I'd like to introduce Jan Lau. Jan Lau is past Secretary Treasurer of the Iowa Federation of Labor and is now the President of the Iowa Alliance for Retired Americans.
Thanks, Mark. And thank all of you for coming. The elections are over, but now the real work is beginning. This is what the elections are all about, is being able to make policy and laws for this nation. So Congress right now is facing this showdown over budget and taxes. We call it the fiscal cliff coming up. But that's an exaggeration. It's really a scare tactic more than anything to scare people from Congress and everybody else into thinking that this is a real crisis, that we absolutely have to give up stuff in order to meet this demand. So there's lots of pressure on Congress to come up with this, what they call the grand bargain. What we may want to make sure of is that it is not a grand swindle. So what we are doing is we're asking our elected officials to make this promise. No more tax cuts for the top 2% of Americans. And no more benefit cuts for Social Security, Medicare, and Medicaid. Now, working people need more security, not less. You hear all these business people talking about the uncertainty, and that's why they can't do anything, because it's uncertain. Well, what about workers? What about individuals? Do you think that they don't have any uncertainty in their lives? What about jobs? Can they be certain about making a living? What about their health care? They have all kinds of uncertainty with health care. What about their retirement? We talk a little bit about Social Security. Social Security is the most successful social program in this country. It's there for us when unexpected tragedy comes about, no matter what age you are. It is well run, it's efficient, it's totally reliable. And the key point here is it pays for itself. It's not paid out of the budget, but it's paid through contributions from workers and employers. So it does not add one dime to the deficit. Let me repeat that. It does not add one dime to the deficit.
That's right.
But at the same time, what they want to do is fix the deficit by cutting Social Security and Medicare. And then those same people that want to cut Social Security and Medicare, even though Social Security does not contribute to the deficit, at the same time, they want to make these tax cuts for the top 2%. So our position is that health care and retirement benefits should not be cut under any circumstances, but certainly not in order to give more tax cuts to the rich. Thank you.
Thank you.